What's up, fans? Our partners here at Bet Online continue to be the number one source for all your betting needs and sports info. Find all the latest odds, news, sports developments, including this year's NBA Finals, NHL Hockey Conference Finals, Major League Baseball, and the latest fighting news, even next season's early NFL futures. Head to the website or use your mobile device to sign up today to receive your 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. Use our promo code BELIEVE, B-L-E-A-V, to get the bonus and get into the action. Bet online where the game starts. Not only does Bet Online sponsor the Boss Man Show, they'll sponsor you too. Get Bet Online today because the Boss Man said so. Man show for the first time ever, coach of the CSUN Matadors out of the Big West Conference, Northridge out there in LA, Coach Trent Johnson. Coach, what's up, man? How you feeling out there, man?
Well, I'm feeling a little better now because last year at this time, I was pretty much doing nothing. And then I got a call on July 23rd where they wanted me to come on as an intern and gave me actually maybe 10 days to sign three or four guys and then to get into school and get into the season. So now I haven't taken a job in March. We've had a chance to put some things together, recruit 8 new players. So got some guys and looking forward to it. We're in spring. We're in our summer workouts. We've got guys in the second summer school session. So things are looking good. You know, I've always managed to try to put myself in situations where I take on these building projects where they say rebuild, right? This is a build. And obviously, you know, Coach Bobby Braswell, who a lot of people in the basketball will remember, the last time they went to the NCAA tournament here was in 2008, 2009, and Coach Braz did an exceptional job. So, doing well.
I hear that, Coach. Let me ask you this, man. The Big West Conference is a tough conference, you know, top to bottom, great coaching out there, man, in that league. So, talk to your guys about who are going to be on your team this year, getting ready for this summer run. Because as you and I both know, Coach, you get better in summertime. It's about, hey, improving your game right now. Tough conference. You know, it's going to be every night going to be a tough matchup for you guys. So, how are you getting your guys mentally ready to get ready for this season come up here real soon, Coach?
Well, for me, every league you've been involved in is probably the toughest league. You know, obviously, fortunately, me, I'm old as dirt, right? So I've been in the Big 12, been in the SEC, been in the Pac-12, you know, and been in the WAC. But the thing I like about this league is a lot of guys who are, you know, they're not a so-so. I hate to use that term power five, but that's where they have aspirations. Everybody does to play at the elite level. And if they're not the power five, it's the NBA. So the players and the coaches in this league, there's a huge healthy, what I say, chip on their shoulder in terms of wanting to prove themselves. But, you know, Dan Munson is with Long Beach State, and, you know, he was at Minnesota, no coach. Well, Dedrick Taylor does an exceptional job over at Cal State Fullerton. You know, Pasternak at Santa Barbara, you know, he's probably his teams in the last 3 or 4 years, which I've studied, have probably been as talented as anybody in the league. And, you know, and there's Coach Les over at Cal Davis, you know, NBA background, playing the NBA. I can go on and on and on. Like Russell Turner is at Irvine, does a good job. So I think the league itself, there's a lot of balance. Obviously, the program that I've just taken over with my assistant coaches has been at the bottom for a long, long time. And we're in a position right now, we're going to make ourselves relevant in terms of how hard we play and how we play and what we do academically and socially. So, but this summer, I've always felt this, and any coach will tell you, that's where players are made. You know, the time you put in the gym from morning, noon, and night. Yeah, the NCAA has certain rules and requirements. Like, for example, we're able to do 1 hour coaching sessions, teaching sessions for 4 hours a week. And then they have an hour of wait. So that's really 4 hours. But the good players, they do more. And yeah, they do more. And then they work and they practice with a purpose. You know, just like I've always said this, you know, big basketball guy over the years, and I like all sports, but you know, you use that term game speed, game shots. And you guys see the Steph Curry and LeBron James. They see all those guys, you know, whoever, the late Kobe, God rest his soul, and Kevin Durant. I can go on. They see all those guys on TV, but they don't see the before. They don't see how much time they put in, you know. And I think that's it's interesting. I want to bring up Steph because he's relevant. Jaren Collins, I was an assistant coach. I recruited Jaren when I was at Stanford, and he sat on that bench with the Golden State Warriors for years, and I know Mike. But so I asked Jaren a question about how much does Steph really work on ball handling. He looked at me like, and he says, "Coach, we'll have a pregame meal, say 3 o'clock." And he says, "Steph's out there like at 2, just dribbling the ball. This is the day of the game. So imagine what he does when he doesn't have a game." So for players in general, I think those are the kind of stories which are facts, and I pride myself on, you know, the facts, not anybody's opinion, you know, not suggestions, results. And I said, so when you start using those as examples, and that's the proven product, there you go. You know, I remember, you know, at LSU, and Rick Barnes, who would coach KD, right? So Rick calls me and says, "Kevin wants to work out. He's going to be shooting a movie in New Orleans." And you know, I said, "Sure." Well, Kevin's guys don't call me. Kevin calls me. And I'd never met Kevin. I saw him on the circuit because of Brooke and Robin Lopez, who I recruited there the same year. So Kevin wants to use the gym. And I said, "Sure." I said, "When you need it?" He said, "Well, Coach, when you guys use it?" I said, "We'll work around you." Well, 8 to 10, he comes in the morning, works on something. 11 o'clock, he's got to drive to New Orleans, which is about 45 minutes an hour, shoot a movie. And we all know how that movie stuff is. I said, "That's the train." Oh, he comes back. He works out from 3 to 5 again. And then we are playing in the evening. So like from like 6 to 9, he just does what he done with my guys. And at that time, I had Johnny O'Brien, who was a second round pick, right? So I asked my players at the time, it was Ralston Turner, Johnny O'Brien, you know, those guys. Justin Hamilton was a part of that group. I says, "What'd you guys do today?" "Oh, because we had class and we lifted and we played." I said, "You see what he did? And you guys want to be there with him. What's wrong with this picture?" but both know, because you've been around some, people don't realize how much time and how much work they put in and it's passionate. But for me, going back to your question, I know I've been long-winded.
No, you're good, Coach. This is why it's a black man on his own show. Take your time. No coach breaks it, Coach. Do your thing.
But those are the kind of things that are important that I try to correlate and try to tell these guys that now that, because I've always been a student of the game and always respected the guys that play this game is, you know, and move forward. So just like, for example, just the portal system, man. You know, there's a lot of guys with the portal system and the NIL money, you know, all about our guys getting paid. But I was mentioning to my guys the other day, I said, "You know what? I lost a guy to NIL money." I said, I get it. But how about you guys going out, winning games, being a good player, and then get your money on the back end? Because that's what happens in the workforce. See, nobody brings that up. So, for example, you know, when you go to the NCAA tournament, the school gets money, mm-hmm. right? You know, so now if you're a player, as opposed to putting yourself in a situation where you're asking before. Now, yeah, the young man from modern day that went to Alabama, yeah, you know, there's a certain elite group. But now you got all these guys asking for it. And like I just chuckled with the one kid. I said, "Son, well, I'm at Cal State Northridge. We won 7 games last year. We're going through a bunch of crap." I said, "I'm sorry, but this ain't happening that round. But I'll be the first one to line up if you get us out the grave." That's where we're at in the grave, right? At the bottom of the till. If you get us out there, then, because that's what happens when you leave. You go get a job, right? You get paid off of what?
Your skill, what you can offer.
Yeah, and you know what? And I don't have all the answers, but that's the correlation. That's what some things I try to share with certain guys. You know what? Because let's face it, you know, the LeBrons, you can go on down the line, the Kevin Durant, the Kyrie Irving, the Steph Curry. Those guys, they're a little different now. They, you know, and they were going to get paid anyway. So I think that's at least in my opinion over the years. But it's that marginal kid, that marginal guy. You got to understand that you're not him. You have to prove yourself. You're not him. And it's the same thing in coaching. It's like a great example. Well, I've been a part of some really good teams. Went to, you know, at Nevada, won a league, Stanford, went to Sweet 16, LSU, went to the Sweet 16, won the SEC, ran the same stuff, got the TCU rebuilding project. You know what? Running the same stuff, no different players. See you later, Coach Johnson. Take a hike. And I get it, you know, but I will say this with that group. It's so funny because Kenrich Williams, who plays in the league now, my staff, we had a group of guys that were ready to go. And we had a couple of guys get hurt, and Kenrich, I shut him down. So the next year when I got fired, I was fired. That next year they went to the NIT, they won it. And 13 of those guys were the scholarship guys that we had. And then the next year, when the Bane came in as a freshman, they went to the NCAA tournament for the first time. There were 8 guys on that floor that we recruited. But people would always ask me, well, how does it make you feel? I said, it makes me feel really, really good. Because, you know, I take pride in myself and this coaching staff that I've been assimilated with. You can look in that rearview mirror, it was a lot better when you left than when you got there. And I think you can relate to that. We all go through that. But that's where my ego's always been wired. And I've been done right by those guys that have played. And I just chuckle sometimes when you get old like me, the guys will always call. Say, Coach, how you doing? And they have all these nice things to say about you. I said, why don't you guys tell the truth? So when you were playing for me, you always say, my middle name was Crazy. I said, oh, what the hell? Now everything's good, right?
Yes. That's how my interns call me, Coach. They call me Crazy. Because this is my baby. I grew this show from the ground up, Coach. This is grassroots. And I know what you mean by having to build something. Like, when you talk about building that program, I had to build this brand. I went from getting denied to who are you to now people respect me. Oh, Boss Man Show. I want to come on this show. He's a good guy. So I've seen the change from when I got started grassroots to now after I've established this and build this brand. I tell my interns, you're representing me. When you do something stupid, I look stupid. So, you
know. And to your passion, it goes, now you're passionate and you love what you do, you're crazy. Because it's like, I can tell when I just first talked to you, it's like, yay. He got too much energy. If you don't get in the way of that, you're going to get run over, right?
Yes. Yes. Every day. Oh, hey, man. I tell people all the time, I'm my own hype man. Every day. Every day I'm living, I'm hype. Because I grew up in Atlanta, not so good part of town. So, you know, I'm happy to be where I'm at, Coach. I could have been somewhere else.
Well, you know, it's interesting. Guys always ask me, like, well, first of all, when I decided to do this, guys never said, man, dang, Johnson, all that money you made, why don't you just go somewhere and try to do nothing? I say, first of all, I've been married for 41 years to the same woman, a black woman, so I ain't got no money. And I said, the second thing, what the hell am I going to do? I don't golf, because I'm that guy. Straight. So Roy Williams was the one who said it best. But I was telling him, just like I told you, 41 years, I ain't got no money, Coach. So he got the nerve to say, you know what? You know, this is Roy, right? Dap gummit. I've been married to one or some 60-some-odd years. I said, well, Coach, you got a hell of a lot more money than I ever had, and you've been around a hell of a lot better player than I ever been. So what you talking about? I said, man, you know, what am I going to do? But you know what? In all honesty and all that, and that's all true, I'm not exaggerating that, is I used to always tell guys, you know what? Yeah, damn, I'm probably going to die in somebody's gym. My wife said, yeah, you well on your way. But when I can't move around and give the energy, I'm not the old guy's going to sit over there and cross his arms. But if I can't move, sit at night and wake up in the morning, toss and turn, that's when it's like, when I stop doing that, okay, no. Because I'm not going to cheat the players. I'm damn sure not going to cheat this game, man. This game has been really good to me. So, anyway.
No doubt, Coach. No doubt. And you know what's good about it, like you said, man, like, we need guys like you in the business because, you know, Some cats aren't like you. We know this is 350 some odd jobs in D1, and everybody do a different way. But your style is a cool style because you actually, you know, you're crazy, but you're crazy within reason, though. That's kind of how I am. So I feel like your style works.
Well, you know what I always tell guys. So okay, so you said I'm crazy. Let's break this down. And I always say, keep it real. You know, and they say, Coach, what you know about that? I say, man, they ain't left the barn. Y'all say keep it real. We say do it right. Whatever that terminology is, right? I says, okay, I'm asking you to play hard. I'm asking you to go to school. I'm asking you to be a good citizen. Man, now I'm crazy for them. So you step out of line one of those three, then I got to do what I got to do. And then I always say this over the years. I'd always say, damn, I know I'm stupid, but I ain't trying to be right. I'm just trying to get it right. I get all the help I can. So why can't you just do what I asked you to do? They'd be like, and I tell them, like, I used to go to the mall with my wife. I don't ask a damn question. I just sit over there. I don't know about Macy's or this. I don't know. I just sit over like a bump on the law. But I ain't going to get in the middle of that. No, you start thinking, you know, where's the common sense in all this, right? I'd be like, yes. Oh. It's, but you know what? You know what, Tony? Because I can just say from Jim talking to you, you can see ain't nothing changed. I mean, it's just like the first interview I had in 99. It's probably like the same one now.
No doubt. And Coach Johnson, I'm now you ain't his age, but you remind me of my pops. My pops is gonna be 82 years old this year.
He's gonna be 82.
82. I'm in my mid-30s. He's 82. So you know when he had me. So
yeah. Well, you know what? My goal, and then I say this to my wife, I say, stop talking like that. See, my goal is to get to 70. And then anything after that, it's a bonus. It's a bonus. What are you talking about? You know, I hope the listeners understand this about the view, because he's probably going to get some bad emails on. I said, Jackie, you go to church, right, babe? You don't see a lot of cats like your husband walking around at 70. He come get us soon.
I said, you just shocked her.
I said, no, I'm just trying to get to 70. Everything after 70 is a bonus. I mean, really, that's how I look at it. And now, you can say what you want about you take care of yourself, you're healthy, you move around, but 70's been my benchmark. It's been my benchmark. And after that, I'm good.
My pops is born at
82?
August 27th, 1940.
He's a Virgo. He's a good man.
So, and he was a coach too.
Well, dang.
So, he wanted me to go into coaching.
How many kids you had?
Uno, me.
Well, God dang. Well, you know what? God bless him, because if you're his only one, that's all good.
Yes, that's why I'm JR, because he's the big boss man. I'm the little one. That's where it comes from.
82, that's huge now.
Yeah, he was a coach and he was a barber, so he always dealt with people.
There you go. He still gets around, walks and all that stuff regularly and all.
He still has me go out and catch routes with him. He throws me the football still at the age he is, at the age I am, yes.
Now that's crazy.
Son, y'all run some routes, son. Yeah, stay in shape, son.
No, that's crazy. That's crazy energy. That's good stuff. That's good stuff.
Yes, that's the lesson that me and my pops have. You know, mom, 72 years old. So, my pops marshaled Dr. King in them back in the day.
Really?
He told me that what a horse arena is, that when he was a child, they had to be across the tracks by dark.
Wow.
That's the history my dad has in him still, 81 years old, be 82 this year. That's the stuff he has to pour into me still. I pour into everybody who I can, because he walked with the man. He was around these civil rights leaders as a kid. He saw how it was.
See, I would love it to be, those are priceless conversations. I'd love to sit there and be a sponge on that. That kind of stuff brings me to my knees, just people that went through that, experienced that. You know, that's like talking to my mom about certain things, and that's why we can never forget, right? We got to always keep getting better, keep educating, and keep moving, right?
Coach, I'm going to tell you something else, to a quick story. I live in the suburbs of Atlanta, 7 mm-hmm. miles from my house where my grandfather was born on a plantation as a sharecropper. 7 mm-hmm. miles where I live at right now.
Mm-hmm.
So my grandfather was born in 1881. Had my father in 40. Think about that. So from my grandfather to me is a span of years, but think about that history though, because I have my grandfather until 87.
Mm-hmm.
He died at 106. So I met my grandfather.
That's huge. That's generational now. Man, oh man.
So I'm prayerful that the Lord key gives me those long living genes that my father and grandfather.
Well, I'll tell you what, you're gonna be running a lot of routes, I can tell you that.
Hey, he keeps me in shape, Coach. I'll tell you that. Hey, when I was a child, we would hit go to the park. I'm hitting baseballs for an hour, shooting hoop for an hour, catching routes for an hour. I ran so fast, I chose football.
Mm.
That was my main thing. That's what I ended up choosing out of all three sports he had me doing.
Well, let me ask you this. Back then, them routes would probably go down around the car, make a left button hook, come back around the tree.
Yes. Yes. Similar there. Yeah. He was like, boy, he'll look at him. do this, run this to the corner, run this to the inside. He would go in his hand and say, run this route, boy. He talked how to switch hit and everything.
I always laugh when these guys, you see them like in the football, like they had this little on Devontae Smith and A.J. Brown, they're out there working out. I said, yeah, that reminds me. I tell my son who works, that reminds me when I was growing up. Yeah, we go down by the Chevy, make a left, button hook back around the tree, ball be right there.
Yes, I remember all those days, Coach, of my dad training me, us guys playing in the hood, football to the darkness. The light pole was a touchdown. Oh, man. I remember those the good days, Coach. And since I got two more for you, Coach, two more questions for you. What is your favorite spot to eat here in the ATL, man?
Oh, come on. It's the place right over by the stadium. Because I went to the Super Bowl when
Rams played the Patriots.
Yeah, it's oh God, I'm going brain dead off the place. It's right there by the stadium.
You talking about the Varsity?
Yeah, and there's the Varsity's one, but there's another. It's a black owned restaurant.
Mary Mac.
There you go.
Mary Mac.
Gotcha. I go Mary Mac. The Varsity is a little bit too upscale for me. I'm like the hole in the wall guy, right?
So. No doubt. You know, and I hate that last night chicken and waffles is gone. I hate that. That's gone now.
Yeah.
I love that. Now, Coach, this I got one more for you. Now, Coach, it's gonna blow your mind. You remember when that SEC tournament when the storm hit the dome?
Yeah, Kevin.
I was a ball boy at that tournament. Both times it happened. That when Dennis Felton had to go play Georgia Tech and win, yeah, and I was a kid, I ball boyed for that Patino and Richardson matchup when they played 95. Yeah.
So I tell you who you got to get on. Have you ever spoke with Paul Hewitt?
Used to be I have not, unfortunately.
Yeah, well, that's the one. That's going to be Coach Hewitt is now with the Clippers.
Yes.
And that Nevada team I had in 04, we played his team in Georgia Tech when we got beaten. They ended up beating Kansas. We had beat Kansas that year by 20 in Nevada. That was Bill Self's first year. So the next game, if we beat Georgia Tech, we play Kansas. But Georgia Tech beat us, and then, then they ended up beating Kansas and went to the Final Four. That's when he had Jerry Jack and all those guys.
Oh, yes. I remember Jerry Jack, my buddy. That's my buddy. Jerry Jack's a buddy of mine. So, yes.
Yeah. Well, anyway.
Coach. Well, Coach, man, look, man, this has been a blast. We'll do this again offline. It'd be even more fun offline.
Well, so all you can do, when you tell people, he ain't crazy now. Hey, all seriousness, I appreciate you having me. Anything I can do, you have my phone number. But more importantly, I just appreciate you having me, and I appreciate what you do because it means everything to the old guys like me who've been around and got guys like you who get it and are building something special. And so my hat's off to you. Really.
Hey, thanks a lot, Coach. And when you come to Atlanta, man, I got to get you to meet my father. You all have a good time talking. Trust and believe. He knows who you are. So I said, yeah, he was LSU, right? I said, yes, he was. He said he was on it. He knew who he knew who you were.
Yeah, well, I ain't running no routes. I can tell you that. Appreciate
I hear
you,
that.
All right.
Hey, Coach, you be safe. Talk to you real soon now.
All right. Thank you.
All right now. What's up, fans? Our partners here at Bet Online continue to be the number one source for all your betting needs and sports info. Find all the latest odds, news, sports developments, including this year's NBA Finals, NHL Hockey Conference Finals, Major League Baseball, and the latest fighting news, even next season's early NFL futures. Head to the website or use your mobile device to sign up today to receive your 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. Use our promo code BELIEVE, BLEAV, to get the bonus and get into the action. Bet online, where the game starts. Not only does Bet Online sponsor the Boss Man Show, they'll sponsor you too. Get it, Bet Online today, because the Boss Man said so.